Today we are going to learn a very important topic in signals systems, that is even, odd, and neither even nor odd signals. So we know what is a signal. Signal in simple terms is basically information. Now what is the meaning of even signal, odd signal, neither even nor odd signals? Okay, so this is a way of classifying a particular signal based on the property called as symmetry. And this topic is going to be a very basic topic as far as signals and systems is concerned. Okay, in each and every particular topic, we have this particular basic concept of even odd. If you consider Fourier series or Fourier transform or Laplace transform, wherever you go, we use this particular concept of symmetry, based on which we classify the signals as even signals, odd signals, neither even nor odd signals. Now, what is symmetry? Now, if you observe the human body, the left side and right side is going to be symmetrical in nature. If you see any flower, the flower is going to be symmetrical in nature. So, if you observe in nature, everything is going to have a symmetry. Symmetry is a very basic thing even in the nature. Okay, and that is why it looks beautiful. In the same way, even in the case of signal systems, symmetry plays a very important role. Now, what is the importance? We know that when we have a signal, the processing of a signal is going to play a very key role. Correct? Having a signal, we have to process the information. So, in the case of processing, it is basically the computations that is going to decide the effectiveness of processing. The number of computations, the amount of time it requires is going to decide the efficiency of the processing signal. Now, if you have a symmetry inside the signal, the processing is going to be very easy. Now, the computations are going to become very much drastically reduced. So that is the reason why we try to classify, if you have a particular signal, we classify the signal as either even signal or odd signal or neither even nor odd signal. Once again, the basis is nothing but symmetry. Now, to understand the concept of symmetry, we require some basic knowledge. One, we should know about what is the concept of time reversal. We have to understand what is time reversal. Second thing, we should know what is the meaning of a continuous time signal, a discrete time signal, and also real signal and complex signal. We will also try to relate a concept in engineering mathematics, which is what we call as transpose. Transpose is a particular operation that we apply on a particular matrix. So we see what is the relation between symmetric matrix and symmetric signal. Okay, so we'll try to relate math with signals. Because in the gate examination, it is very much important that you are able to relate one particular topic with the other topic. Now, we can easily relate whatever we have learned as a symmetric matrix, skew symmetric matrix, with the of even signals and odd signals. We will also learn about this particular thing. So as I've told you, this is a very interesting topic, very important topic, very basic topic for the signals and systems subject. So let us start with the of basic thing about what is a time reversal. So time reversal is basically, if you have a particular signal, for example, I have a signal something like this. Let me call the signal as x of t, and t is the independent variable on the x-axis. Now, what is the meaning of time reversal? I'm going to take t is equal to 0 as a plane, and I'm going to swap the right side components onto the left side and left side components onto the right side. That is what we call as a concept of time reversal. It is simply, okay, moving the right side information onto the left side and left side information onto the right side. This is what we call as a concept of time reversal. It is simply like a plane mirror. Okay, if you observe a plane mirror, any image in a plane mirror, for example, if a batsman who is right-handed is batting, now if you see in a particular plane mirror, it looks as if he is a left-handed batsman. So same concept you are going to see here. Okay, whatever right side information, after time reversal, it will be on the left side. Whatever left side information of t is equal to 0, that will go to the right side. That is what we call as a time reversal. Now, for the signal x of t, the time reverse signal is going to be if you move the signal onto the left side, whatever right side part, that is something like this. This part, which is on the left side, if you move to the right side, so the operation that we are applying is x of t replacing t with t of minus t. You won't have x of minus t. And x of minus t is what we call as a time reversed signal. Okay, so now we have learned about time reversal. Now second thing is, what is a continuous time signal and a discrete time signal? Continuous time signal, as the name suggests, a signal is defined at each and every instant of time. Then we call it as a continuous time signal. If a signal is defined only at some discrete values of time or discrete instants of time, we call it as a discrete time signal. For example, if I draw a signal something like this, let my signal is starting somewhere from minus 1 to the value of 5. Now this signal is going to be a continuous time signal because at each and every instant of time, if you observe from minus 1 to 5, there are infinite instants between minus 1 and 5. There are infinite instants between minus 1 and 5. But each and every instant, the signal is defined. We call it as a continuous time signal. Whereas, if you see its counterpart, which is a discrete time signal, the signal is available only at some instants of time. Here, we represent a discrete time signal with an independent variable time as small n. And here, the y-axis is going to be x of n. Y-axis is represented as x of n. X-axis as, okay? So this is a continuous time signal and it's a discrete time signal. This information is also required when we learn the concept of even and odd signals. Third thing, real and complex signals. Now what is a real valued signal and what is a complex valued signal? Do we have any signal in our practical real life where we have a complex valued signal? The answer is no. Wherever signals that you observe, whatever, it can be a temperature signal, it can be a pressure signal, it can be a voltage signal, it can be a current signal, or it can be any other signal which is physical in nature. It can be sound, it can be velocity, whatever it is. So all the signals, all the information that is available mostly seem to be a real signal or real valued signals. It means that if I am able to write the function x of t, which is a signal itself, generally it will only have the real component if I'm talking about the physical signals, and the imaginary component is generally equal to zero. In that case, we call the particular signal as a real valued signal. Sometimes we will also have the components of the imaginary component also. The imaginary component is not equal to zero. We call it as a complex valued signals. But basically, your real valued signal is a subset of a complex valued signals. Now, if we don't have any physical signal which is available for a complex value, then why we discuss it? It is a very good question. You can think about it. But the answer is very simple. When we deal about the processing of a particular signal, then we use some complex analysis, where in the case of complex analysis, we try to represent a particular signal or its transform in frequency domain, sometimes in complex domain. So therefore, it is going to simplify the analysis or computation. So therefore, the complex analysis is going to be very simple, is going to be very important. And that is the reason why even in your engineering mathematics, we have a particular topic on complex analysis. Okay, because it plays a very key role in the processing of a particular signal. So therefore, on a brief note or in a simple note, we just have a particular sort of a division of or a classification as a real valued signals and a complex valued signals. But if you see the practical scenario, probably we don't have the particular classification. We generally have a real valued signals only. But in the case of theoretical analysis, we definitely require an assumption of having a signal being complex or the representation of a signal in terms of complex. So as far as the relation with the mathematics is concerned, so based on the property of symmetry, if we go to the content of even, odd, neither, even, nor, odd, which is very important, based on symmetry,
signals can be classified
based on signal, based on symmetry. I mean, the signals can be classified as, number one, even signals. Okay. Second one, odd signals. Third one, neither even nor odd. So, signals can be classified in terms of a symmetry based on a property of symmetry as even signals, odd signals, and neither even nor odd. Now, first, if we start with an even signal, we have already learned about the topic of time reversal. If I apply the time reversal on a particular signal, it means that if I apply a time reversal on a particular signal, left side components go to the right side and the right side components come to the left side. That if it is equal to that of x of t, x of minus t is equal to that of x of t, we can call the signal is going to be even, simply as an even signal. Okay, so whenever we have a representation of a t in the open brackets, it is a continuous time signal. Okay, so whenever we have a continuous time signal, we have a representation of time in terms of small t and we represent a open brackets. In the case of a discrete time signal, the same can be written as closed brackets, in the place of t you will have n, it is equal to the root of x of n. Of course, we can call it as a even signal, but here it is in a discrete domain. And by this time, we know what is a continuous time signal and a discrete time signal. What is an example of an even signal? Can you try for an example? We have some trigonometric signals like cos t, the sinc function itself, the gate function, a rectangular function. Or if I write that x of t equal to t square, or the examples of, or x of t is equal to mod of t. These are the examples of a even signal. Now in the case of a cos t function, we know how the cos t is a periodic function, a sinusoidal function. Now here if you observe, whatever left side information is equal to that of right side information. This is how, just by looking up at a particular signal, you can say whether it is going to be even. Whenever the left side information is equal to the right side information, is same, identical to that of the right side information, we can call it as a even signal. Or in terms of what we have discussed as a formula, if I apply the time reversal on the signal, if I apply the time reversal on the above signal, then what happens? All the left side information moves to the right side. All the right side information comes to the left side. So first of all, I want to move all my right side information onto the left side. All the left side information onto the right side. Correct? So here if you observe, both of them look identical. That x of minus t is equal to that of x of t. So this sort of signal is what we call as an even signal. We call it as a even signal. And similarly, what is an odd signal? Okay, we have seen about an even signal. Simply, when I want to represent an odd signal. Now, x of minus t is equal to minus of x of t. Or I can write minus of x of minus t is equal to x of t. Either I can write, keeping a minus here, x of minus t is equal to minus of x of t, or what I can do is that I can keep a minus here, minus of x of minus t is equal to x of t. We call it as a odd signal. We can call it as a odd signal. Now the same in the case of discrete time. If I add a minus, then it is going to be a odd signal. Now what I mean to say here, apply time reversal, and for the time reverse signal, you just multiply the amplitude with minus 1. You just multiply the amplitude of x of minus t with that of minus 1. If it is equal to that of x of t, we can call it as a odd signal. whether it is continuous time or it is a discrete time. Whenever you apply the time reversal, and then if you apply 1 minus to its amplitude, then if it is equal to the top, the signal x of t, we can call it as a odd signal, or we can also call it as anti-symmetric signal. We can call the same signal as a anti-symmetric signal. Anti-symmetric signal. Any example for it? We have the sine function itself is going to be an example. X of t is equal to t itself is an example. The signum function is also an example. Now, in the case of sine function, if I represent a sine function, it is a sine function. Now, first of all, I want to apply the time reversal on this particular signal. Let me consider the signal as x of t. Now, when I apply the time reversal, what happens? All the left side information onto the right side. Now, this signal is x of minus t. Now, what I told you, you apply one more minus. If I apply one more minus, what happens? Already there is a negative value. Now, if I apply minus, this comes to the positive value. This becomes a positive. For example, here, I'm going to have minus 1. Now, for this particular signal, if I apply minus of it, minus of x of minus t, then this signal comes to the upper part. Okay, this is what we call as a amplitude reversal. Technically, we call this particular operation as a amplitude reversal. So, this information moves to the upper side. So, it is going to become plus. If it is a plus, upon applying the minus, it becomes minus. So, similarly, this information, whatever is there here, if you apply minus to it, it comes to the bottom part. Now, if you observe minus of x of minus t with the dot of x of t, they look identical. Now, this is an example of an odd signal. Okay. So, similarly, if you look at a particular signal, x of t is equal to t. X of t is equal to c. T is basically a line with a slope equal to 1 passing through the origin. Now, this signal is also an example of an odd signal. Now, we can just by looking at it, we can say whether a signal is going to be even or odd. How can we say that? In the case of an even signal, for example, some information is available in the first quadrant. This is a quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3 and quadrant 4, right? So, if some information is available in the first quadrant, if the same information is available in the second quadrant, it is an even signal. Or, let me assume that I have a signal in the fourth quadrant. If the same information is available in the third quadrant, we can call it as an even signal. It means that the right side information is equal to the left side information. It is an even signal. In the case of an odd signal, for example, if I have an information in the first quadrant, if the same information is available with a negation, with a minus sign, here it is plus 1, if I have it with a minus 1, it means that if I have an information in the first quadrant, the same information if I have in the third quadrant, I can call it as an odd signal. Okay, so this particular signal is what we call as a signum function. It is an odd signal. If you apply the similar operation, you will get that minus of x of minus t is equal to that of x of t. So, signum function. Okay. Similarly, for example, if I have an information somewhere here. In the second quadrant, I have some information. Now, this is one. The same information has to be available in the case of a fourth quadrant. Then also I can say it is going to be a odd signal. It means that something like this. Either like this or like this. The information has to be same. Here it is constant, here also it is constant. Here it is constant, here also it is constant. If you look at a sinusoidal signal also, whatever information you have, the same information is available in the third quadrant. Whatever information you have, the same information is available in the third quadrant. We call it as an odd signal. Here also, a line passing through the origin with a slope equal to 1. Whatever information is there here, the same information is available in the third quadrant. We can call it as a odd signal. So just by looking at it, we can say whether the signal is going to be an even signal or an odd signal. Or mathematically, if we apply the time reversal on a particular signal, it is equal to same signal, we can call it as an even signal. Time reversal with an amplitude reversal, or time reverse signal, if you multiply 1 more minus 1, then if it is equal to that of x of t, the original signal, then we can call it as a odd signal. Now, we can draw a parallel between what we are learning as a even and odd signals in signal systems with that of symmetric and skew symmetric matrix in the case of mathematics. So, in the case of a mathematics, we have an operation called as transpose. That if I have a matrix A, the transpose of A is what we call as A transpose. Now, if the transpose of A is equal to A, after applying the transpose, if it is equal to the same matrix A, we can call it as a symmetric matrix. We can call it as a symmetric matrix. When I apply the transpose on A, if it is equal to minus A, it is a skew symmetric matrix. If I apply the transpose on a matrix, if it is equal to minus of the same matrix, we can call it as a skew symmetric matrix. A transpose is equal to A, A transpose is equal to minus A. Now, the symmetric and skew symmetric matrix knowledge is almost similar to the top what we are learning as a even and odd signals. X of minus t is equal to x of t. In the case of signal systems, in the place of transpose, you are applying time reversal. Okay, we can call it as a symmetric or even signal. X of minus t is equal to minus of x of t. We call it as anti-symmetric or skew symmetric or odd signal. So whatever information, whatever knowledge that you have gained in mathematics as a transpose is basically almost equivalent to that of time reversal in the case of the signals and systems. In the case of mathematics, we will also learn that any matrix which is non-symmetric, what is a non-symmetric matrix? Non-symmetric matrix is nothing but A transpose is not equal to that of plus or minus A. Generally, A transpose, if it is equal to A, we can call it as a symmetric matrix. If it is equal to minus A, we call it as a skew symmetric. In a case where both of them are not satisfied, we can call it as a non-symmetric. We can call it as a non-symmetric matrix. Okay, A transpose is not equal to the top plus or minus A. We can call it as a non-symmetric matrix. Now, similar to that, X of minus T is not equal to the top plus or minus X of T. We can call it as a neither even nor odd signal. Neither even nor odd signal. Neither even nor odd signal. In the case of mathematics, if I have a non-symmetric matrix, we can write it as a summation of symmetric and skew symmetric parts. For example, if I have a matrix which is not symmetric, I can write it as symmetric part plus skew symmetric part. Now, what is the symmetric part going to be? The symmetric part is going to be A plus A transpose divided by 2. Now, the skew symmetric part is equal to A minus A transpose divided by 2. If you add both of them, what are we going to have? A plus A transpose by 2 plus A minus A transpose by 2, it is going to be equal to A. Correct? In the same way, when I have a function which is going to be neither even nor odd, I can write X of T is equal to X of T plus X of minus T divided by 2 plus X of T minus X of minus T divided by 2. Now this part is going to be an even component, and the other part
is a odd component.
So whenever we have a particular function x of t, which is neither even nor odd, in that case, we can write it as a summation of summation of even component and the odd component, where the even component is given by x of t plus x of minus t divided by 2, and the odd component is given by x of t minus x of minus t divided by. So let us take a particular example. We have already seen the examples of even signals and odd signals. Now let us see an example of a signal which is neither even nor odd. So if I have a signal which is graphically represented something like this, we call it as a unit step signal. We call it as a unit step signal. Now, if I ask you a question that whether it is going to be an even signal or an odd signal or a neither even nor odd, what is the answer going to be? Whether it is going to be an even signal or an odd signal or neither even nor odd, what is the answer? Okay, you have to just check what right side information and the left side information. Now, if you see, right side information is nowhere related to the top left side information. Right side information is 1, left side information is 0. It means that there is no relation. Okay, or there is no similarity between the top, the right side information and the left side information. So such a particular signal is what we call as a non-symmetric signal or a neither even nor odd signal. Neither even nor odd signal. So in such case, we can write the function which is non-symmetric as a even component plus the odd component. Where the formula for even component, as we have seen just before this particular expression, is u of even of t is going to be u of t plus u of minus t divided by 2. And u odd of t is u of t minus u of minus t divided by 2. Correct? So now, considering u of t is my signal, I have to find the even component and the odd component, which is also going to be a very important expression later on in the concepts of Fourier series and Fourier transform. So now, let us find about what is the even component. I already know u of t. I should know u of minus t. What is u of minus t going to be? U of t, apply the time reversal, it is going to be u of minus t. So considering a u of t function, so u of, correspondingly, the value of u of minus t is just the time reversal. Okay? So now what I have to do? U of t plus u of minus t. U of t plus u of minus t, here the information is 1. To the right side for t greater than 0. This is t equal to 0, right? So just to right side of t equal to 0 is t greater than 0. So here the value is equal to 1. U of t is equal to 1 for t greater than 0. Here u of minus t is equal to 0 for t greater than 0. So if you add these two informations, the right side informations, okay, then 1 plus 0 is going to be 1. Left side information, I can, without looking at it itself, I can say it's going to be something like this. Because the function is going to be even in nature. Even though divided by 2 is not there, but still the function is going to be even in nature. So it means that when I know the right side information, I should not bother about the left side information when it is an even signal. So what I'm trying to do here, I'm just concerned about what is the right side information. Here it is 1, here it is 0. So 1 plus 0 is going to be 1. And I'm not looking about this particular information, I'm just drawing it. Because we know it's going to be an even component. And the even component will definitely have the same information as that of the right side component. Now, this is completely equal to 1. So, u of t plus u of minus t is a DC signal which is equal to 1 unit. It is a DC signal which is having 1 unit. Now, what I have to do is that in order to get the value of u even of t, I have to divide whatever u of t plus u of minus t is there. I just have to be dividing it by 2. So if I do that, then the ultimate signal is going to be, the ultimate signal is going to be something. This is nothing but u of t plus u of minus t divided by 2. Or simply I can write it as u even of t. Now similarly, you can also draw the u odd of t. What we have to do? U of t minus u of minus t. So you have to subtract u of minus t from the top u of t. If you subtract u of minus t from the top u of t, what are we going to have? What I have to do is here, I should, instead of having plus, I should have a minus sign. So if I have a minus sign, then what happens to the signal? So 1 minus 0. Just if I'm concentrating on the right side. Here I have a 1, here I have a 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1. Now, I should not bother about the left side, because left side is going to be, because I have an information in the first quadrant, because it is an odd component, even though I am looking for u of t minus u of minus t divided by 2. I know that because u of this component is going to be odd, so definitely u of t minus u of minus t is also going to be odd. So what I can do here, 1 minus 0 is 1. The left side component is going to be in the third quadrant. Right side component, if it is in one first quadrant, if it is an odd signal, I should not look at it. It's not required to look at it. I can directly write, because the information is present in the first quadrant, now the left side information has to be there in the third quadrant. What is the reason for it? Because it is a odd signal. So definitely if I have an information on the right side, the same information will be available in the left side, but in the third quadrant. Okay, so 1, here it is, minus 1. Even if you do here also, you'll get the same answer, okay? Here it's 0, here it is 1. 0 minus 1 is going to be equal to minus 1. Now, in order to get the complete odd component, I have to just divide this by 2. So, if I just divide by 2, what happens? In the place of 1, I'll have 1 by 2. In the place of minus 1, I'm going to have minus 1 by 2. So, the ultimate signal is going to be equal to the top. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. This is u odd of t. Now, this particular signal, u of t minus u of minus t, is actually what we call as a signum function. We call it as a signum function. We can call it as a signum function, okay? Okay, we have a particular technical term. It's a standard signal for us. We call it as a signum function. If u of t minus u of minus t is a signum function, if you just divide it by 2, this is going to be equal to half signum function. It is a half signum function. So, the total function u of t, which is equal to u even of t plus u odd of t, can be written as 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 signum of t. It's the even component, we got it as a 1 by 2, and the odd component is 1 by 2 signum of t, which is an important expression for the examination. So, I will end the class with a homework problem. That if I have a signal, first of all you answer whether it is even or odd. Second, if it is not even nor odd, in that case find even component and odd component. Okay, so you can message the answer in the comment section. So, as an extension of this particular topic, in our actual class, okay, in the actual class, we will see the extension of it for the complex valued signals also. Basically, here, it is a real valued signal, because completely, the signal is on a particular dimension, okay, a single dimension. Now, the other dimension is time, the signal is taking only one dimension. In the case of a complex valued signal, the signal will have two dimensions. Signal itself is going to have two dimensions. One is the real dimension, the other is the imaginary dimension. So, real dimension, imaginary dimension with respect to the dot of time. So, we are going to have three components. Okay, time is an independent variable. Now, the signal is itself going to have two dimensions. Now, because it is having one dimension and there is no j here, we can simply call it as a real signal. So, whatever we have seen today is basically for real signals. Now, in the actual class, we are going to also learn about the complex valued signals. And also, we will see what is the product of even signals, what is the product of odd signals, what is the product of even and odd signals. Can you please answer it in the comment section? What is the product of even signals? What is the product of odd signals? What is the product of two neither even nor odd signals?